Taj Mahal, one of the seven wonders of the world, is getting affected today. How is it getting affected? The smoke, the pollution from the factories nearby, the automobile exhaust is having adverse effect on this Taj Mahal. Now, what is present in the atmospheric pollution, or how is this pollution in the air affecting Taj Mahal? Let's see. The industries release pollution. This consists of the oxides of carbon, sulfur and nitrogen. These are the different pollutants which are present in the emission from these industries. The oxides released, especially sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide, when these combined with water in the atmosphere, that is water vapor present in the atmosphere, they lead to the formation of acids. They lead to the formation of sulfuric and nitric acid. And then they cause acid rain. So, acid rain is a form of precipitation like rain, fog, snow and so on, which is more acidic than normal water. So, the pollutants present in the air, that is the oxides of sulfur and nitrogen, when they combine with the water vapor present in air and then when it rains or precipitates, it contains the acids. As the oxides present in air, they combine with water to form the corresponding acids. So when it precipitates, it contains acids. And this form of precipitation we call acid rain. Let's see how we get nitric acid. The main source of pollution or main source of the oxides of nitrogen is the combustion of engines. The internal combustion engines or the automobile exhaust, this is the major source for producing the oxides of nitrogen. This nitrogen monoxide combines with oxygen to form nitrogen dioxide, and when this nitrogen dioxide combines with water present in the atmosphere, it forms nitric acid and nitrous acid. But nitric acid is the major product being formed. So this is how we get nitric acid in the atmosphere. Similarly, for sulfur, sulfur is also a major pollutant in the atmosphere. It can be formed by the burning of fuels and from the industrial exhausts. So when we get sulfur, it reacts with oxygen to form sulfur dioxide. This sulfur dioxide further reacts with oxygen to form sulfur trioxide. And when this comes in contact with water, it forms sulfuric acid. So now these acids, that is nitric acid and sulfuric acid, which are now present in atmosphere. Since they are now present in atmosphere, so any form of precipitation that takes place, whether rain, fog, snow and so on, so any form of precipitation contains these acids, and so we call this type of precipitation as acid rain. Now, this acid rain has some very detrimental impacts. Let's see what are the different impacts of this acid rain. So, if you take some vinegar, which is acetic acid in a glass, and you add a chalk piece to it, this chalk piece is actually calcium carbonate. So you'll observe, after some time, the chalk piece starts disintegrating. This is how acid rain is affecting the monuments, the marble and limestone monuments. This is how Taj Mahal is getting affected. So when limestone, so CaCO3 is limestone or marble, when marble comes in contact with acid, say sulfuric acid, it forms calcium sulfate, carbon dioxide and water. So it starts to disintegrate or decompose. So acid rain is having an adverse effect on the monuments made up of marble or limestone. Another detrimental impact of this acid rain is that it affects the soil fertility. When this acid rain enters the soil, it removes the important minerals like calcium and potassium. This calcium and potassium are very important for enriching the soil fertility, as these are removed by the acids like nitric acid and sulfuric acid, so the soils lose their fertility. This forest, the trees of this forest in New York, they died because of acid rain. Another serious impact of acid rain is on the aquatic life. This acid rain, when it enters the water bodies, it adversely affects the aquatic life, and hence the plants and animals in these water bodies die because of acid rain. Hence, these are the serious or the detrimental impacts of acid rain.